He said, well, you might just wanna, and I thought that's kinda strange with him to tell me, well, you might wanna get another estimate. I'm like, okay, you know, got nothing loose. We've been waiting this long and dealing with this here 2 weeks. We can go make it a little while longer. So I called this other person out. I mean, like I said, we are on different walks of life because we know each of us is be facing and dealing with different circumstances, different situation. It might be financial, it might be health, it might be peace, or whatever. The word is still the same. God ain't changing. It hasn't changed. What his requirements is still the same. Whatever you might be believing God for. Hallelujah. And like I said, just I went on to call another opponent out, and the strange thing, they came out, and I think they gave us a quote, I think we said like $800 or $900. All right. Yeah, I can deal with that. I mean, praise God, we might have to take an offering at the church now. We can maintain that. Hallelujah. But God is so good. This type of man, he came out on a Friday night, about 9 o'clock at night, which I was shocked, you know. And, you know, and come on, 9 o'clock, I didn't finish about 11:30 at night. And he really didn't communicate anything, but I called him the next day, which was a Saturday, and he said, I'll be out there later on to show you what's going on. And he came out that Saturday evening and showed me where AT&T had run a line through there. I guess when they bore the line to lay the fiber optic cable, they had cut through my sewer line. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So to me, that is a miracle. Hallelujah. And, you know, I would love to say that it all ended there and everything went well, but it didn't stop there. I mean, you have to continue to press on regardless. Even though time has seen things might be coming in your favor, you still got to keep on. I mean, that's what Trevor talked about, faith. Not, you know, based on things when it may be looking good, you see the light at the end of the tunnel. You see the thing begin to turn. You still have to continue to have your confidence in God and believe in Him and trust in Him regardless. Well, if I had to repair myself, He will provide the finances for me to do it. Hallelujah. Yeah. That's what y'all have in believing, faith, and trust in God. Thank you, Lord. And I kept coming. Hallelujah. Monday, Wednesday night, Sunday. Keep serving. Kept praising Him. Hey, when the sister admonished us to praise the Lord, I was up there raising my hand. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I praise you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. And I said, this gentleman told me what it was, and I called AT&T and talked with them, and they said, well, that's not our problem. The contractors we hired, they the one, you know, did the work for us. You had to contact them. And of course I called them and talked with them, and guess what? They tell me, ain't none of my problem. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Well, by that time, Brother Wayne probably just about done had enough. That's why I say you have to pray. I mean, God knows your limits. Hallelujah. He won't give you no more than you can bear. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And I had to talk to the contractor. He said it's not one of his problems because the line wasn't highlighted. That particular lines or the utilities weren't identified. And I said, well, so I had to go back in. I mean, I spent, it was how much time on the telephone call and this one and talking on that one. I mean, just you get squished from here to here and here. I mean, you know, it could be seemingly frustrating. And but go ahead and wrap this up. Hallelujah. I hope we can do this 5 minutes. I'm sorry. Okay. I know. Well, although that 5 minute clock, we're going to burn that up. Hallelujah. And I called an ATM back, and I just basically blunted. I said, "You mean to tell me?" See, a lot of times we as Christians, we've been taught to be, you know, nice and easy. And that's good. There are sometimes we got to have a little fire on us. Hallelujah. I mean, you got to let the devil know, no, this is not going to happen. It's time for you to let this thing go and resolve this issue. And so I told him, I said, "You mean to tell me that this is the answer that you're going to give me, that it's not your responsibility to take care of this problem?" And he said, "Sir, I tell you what, let me call this in contractor back up and I'll take care of it." So he did call a contractor, sent me a letter, threatened the contractor, take them off their contract list. And a long story short, praise God, of course the plumbing was fixed. Praise God, they just sent us a check and reimbursed for all our money and expenses that we have. And hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. But if it takes steadfastness and continually, you're believing and trusting God, God's going to work on your behalf, regardless of whatever might be going on. I mean, this was the same thing I dealt with when the enemy attacked my health. What the doctors was telling me, praise God, and the information they provided to me, whether I was going to receive that or not. When they told me one thing, I went and found somebody else. I went to another one. I mean, this is a stand that I took. Till I found somebody that was going to be in agreement with what I was saying, regarding what the word was saying. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And the same thing you may be facing, yeah, you said, well, you might have to go through. True enough, you probably, more likely, it's a good chance you might have to go through whatever you might be facing. Hallelujah. But rest assured, God is with you. And you have to maintain your faith that you believe in Him, that the outcome is going to be in your favor regardless. But the scripture says, in the end, we win. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. And Paul says, "I'm be from out from the body to be in the presence of the Lord." Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. It would be good that He would deliver us instantly. Hallelujah. But sometimes we are required for the blessing of God, for the favor of God, for God to come, to allow you to go through whatever you might be facing. Praise God. But you want to know what is His will. Glory to God. Even Jesus Himself, when He was facing the hour of temptation, He said, "Lord, Father, if this be Your will, let it be another way." But He said, "Nevertheless, hallelujah, not my will, but Your will be done." Glory to God. He has still had to go through all that painfulness that we would desire, or you might have been thinking that He would be delivered, the Father would have delivered, but that was the will of God. The same thing with us. What is the will of God for your life? Is it your will of God for you to go through, or Him to deliver you? But whether He deliver you, hallelujah, or not, you still have a mindset that you're going to praise and bless His name. Glory to God. And if you need a scripture, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise. Turn to John 9. Thank you, Lord. And this scripture blessed me. Hallelujah. Because we want God, in our prayer, we want Him to hear us. And I like that what David said in Psalm 116, "I love the Lord." Hallelujah. "Because He heard me and my supplication." Yes, yes. Glory to God. "And because He heard me, therefore," praise God, "I will serve the Lord." Hallelujah. "All the days of my life." Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Bless Your name. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You in John 9:21? Thank you. 31? Yes. Hallelujah. Bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. Now, we know that God heareth not sinners. The only thing that God want to hear from the sinners, "Lord, I'm sorry," or "repent of heart." That's what He's looking for from a sinner. But if any man be a worshiper of God, and doeth his will, him he heareth. Glory to God. If you become a worshiper of God, hallelujah, and worship him in the spirit and truth, glory to God. You is the one God heareth. Thank you, Father. So it pays when the lady or the sister is admonishing up here, let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's get in his presence. Because if you praise him in here, or wherever you may be, praise God, he's working on your behalf. Glory to God. While I was out here on those other nights, and while I'm at home and praising him, he was working on my behalf, giving me favor with these contractors, giving me favor with these people. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And we need the favor of God to work on our behalf. I mean, we need it more so than ever since. Hallelujah. We need God and see him move in the midst of us. And on our behalf and work in miracles. Because you see him do it one time, you will believe him again. Glory to God. He promised, I'll never leave you, nor never forsake you. I will always be with you, even into the end of the earth. When he said that, praise God, you can rest assured, you can put confidence in that. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I mean, he has so many promises that laid out before us. Praise God. The Bible said, we are his children, and the sheep will pay. He said, we being evil, know how to give good gifts unto our children. What about your heavenly Father? Don't he know how to give, praise God, unto you that have need? Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. He said, I withhold back not my only son, but I gave him for you, hallelujah, to be a ransom, hallelujah, to pay a price for each and every one, not only for us, but for the sins of the whole world. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. All you say, ask. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And it shall be given unto you. Thank you, Father. Bless your name, Lord. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. For this is the confidence in him. That we ask anything. Can you imagine he has given you a promise anything? Somebody believe. 1 John 5:14. I just get filled in and didn't think that was true. That was just something Brother Wayne made up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 1 John 5, praise God. Thank you, Lord. Verse 14. And this is the confidence. I mean, don't you know that this gives you confidence in your God? Hallelujah. That he's so confident within in himself that he can put this out there like this.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, God. He said, I'm just bragging on God this morning. He's big enough and bad enough to put this out there to anyone. Just like he said, whosoever. He's looking for someone. Whosoever who I can show up in their life and show you who I am. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. Praise God. What is anything? Do you know what his will is concerning you? I know, rest assured, I know for certain his will, praise God, in my situation, praise God, that me not being frustrated or aggravated continually in that, I know for sure, thank God, that it dealt a blow to our peace. Hallelujah. For he is my peace. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That was an anything for me. Hallelujah. Lord, what you did with this plumbing, that's an anything. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I don't know if you have anything in your life that's going on that you think God can handle. I mean, anything. This is not a promise based on mine. I think what I'm saying. Hallelujah. But this is a promise from God himself. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. And verse 15, that if we know that he heareth us, See, that means you got to spend some time in prayer. You got to get comfortable in your Father's presence that you can ask Him for anything, and that He's willing, praise God, to provide.